What is up, YouTube? I'm Devon DaVinci, leader of the Renaissance Crew, and you're watching DaVinci Reacts. I had a couple people ask me, how do you join the Renaissance Crew, or what is the Renaissance Crew? The Renaissance Crew is the subscription base. So if you're subscribed to this channel, you are a member of the Renaissance Crew. Congratulations. Now, this video, depending on what the title is going to be very different, so you need to pay attention. There's two different types of videos I do reactions to. I do DaVinci Reacts videos and DaVinci Watch videos. The title, it'll be in the title, so you'll know exactly which one you're watching. If you're watching DaVinci React, you're good. You don't have to do any extra steps. If you're watching DaVinci Watch, then there are steps you'll have to take in order to get the full experience of the video. Normally, DaVinci Watch videos are only for videos that have copyright issues, videos that tend to get blocked on YouTube. So you have to go the extra step in order to be able to fully experience the regular reaction. And here's the steps you have to take. So pay close attention, because if you skip over this, you're going to go to the video and wonder why there's no sound or why the video is obscured in some way or something, and you're going to be lost. So pay attention. In the description box of every DaVinci React video, there is an original link. The original link will take you to the original video. What you have to do is go down to the description box, right-click the original link, and click Open in New Window. When the new window pops up, take the mouse, put it in the corners or whatever of the window, and try to shrink it down so that it fits within this reaction video. So you should have the window that has my reaction to it, and shrunk down somewhere in the corner of this video, you should have the original video. Now, when the original video is sitting there, put it all the way at the beginning, make sure that it's set on 0000 so that none of the video has started. I'm going to give a countdown. 3, 2, 1, go. When I say go, hit the play button on the original video. When that happens, you should be watching my reaction sunk in time with the original video. So it'll be as if it was a regular reaction. If you have a phone or a tablet or something that won't allow you to play two videos at once, the best thing I would suggest is go and get a VPN. There are free VPNs. But since I don't use any free VPNs, I can't really recommend anything. I would suggest going online and searching up the best free VPNs you can get. And make sure you go to like forums or something like that. Don't go to the VPN's website, because they're going to tell you everything they want you to hear. Go look up actual like third-party reviewers and try to get the best information you can. And I personally use NordVPN. NordVPN is one of the best investments I've ever made in my life. I still use it to this day. And this isn't a sponsorship for me saying that, even though it should be. This is just me giving the honest truth. NordVPN is one of the best things I ever did. It allows you to switch to different countries, and in those countries, the video will likely not have been blocked, so you will get both the React version and the Watch version. Because, again, I upload two versions every single time. The React version and the Watch version. If you don't see the version with sound, then it was blocked in your country. That's it. Now, let's get into this. This is The Inbetweeners Season 2, Episode 6. It's called Exam Time, which is interesting. So it's going to be a lot of pressure, a lot of stress, and a lot of cringe, hopefully. Let's jump into this and see what it has to offer. Remember, countdown 3, 2, 1, go.
Been a strange few months for me and my friends. My plan to raise our social standing had been a qualified success. To be honest, if anything, we'd slipped down the social ladder. Although I did now know the worst way to impress a girl, kill a fish. But the end was in sight. The end of term, the end of year, and if I didn't pass my AS levels, the end of my life. But at least Simon wasn't feeling the pressure.
Hi, Simon.
Huh? Oh, shit.
Revising hard?
Oh, yeah, shit.
Are you okay?
Sorry. Bit wet. Mum will get it out though, not to worry.
Sorry to disturb you. I wanted to ask if you could do me a favour.
Yes.
You don't know what it is yet.
Her friend's like,
go on.
Can I come over to yours and revise sociology with you?
Yes, God yes. Come over anytime. Come over now.
Well, I can't come over now.
No, of course not.
But this is really great
of
you, Simon. It's
You're
so hard
good.
To revise at the moment because we've got the builders in.
Oh, right. Is that a euphemism?
Sorry?
You know, like having the painters in.
Sorry, I don't really get it.
I don't either.
Oh, no, don't worry. It wasn't that funny.
What did you mean?
Come on, Simon, what does it mean?
Oh, just, having the painters in means being on your period, right?
Oh, my God.
When you said you couldn't concentrate because you had the builders in, I thought that might be a euphemism for you being on your period.
There goes that cringe.
Right.
There goes that cringe.
I see.
It wasn't that funny, really.
No, it's fine. I get it. See you tonight, then?
Cool. See you tonight.
Okay. I'm actually going to that freak's house.
So despite him behaving like
a friend wasn't feeling him at all.
Carly was actually going round to Simon's. And even stranger things were happening at Jay's.
The hell? Is that his sister?
No, Jay. I'm not ready, sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I don't want to rush things either.
Really?
Yeah. I'd hate for you to think that I'm only after you for sex.
Wow.
But just so you know, if you do want to touch me downstairs, then I'm totally fine with that.
Wow, Jay's a player.
I'm okay for now.
Jay's apparently a player.
I better go, my mum's expecting me. And shouldn't you be revising?
Yeah, maybe I should. But when you're near me, Chloe, I can't think about anything else.
You're so sweet.
Wow.
Come on, I'll walk
down. Wow.
Unless you want to...
Okay.
No, thanks.
Wow.
Yeah, no. Come on.
Unlike the others, my revision strategy went beyond trying to get into girls' knickers. I was studying hard. And by hard, I mean doing literally anything to avoid revising.
I said no, Mum. I had a bath yesterday.
At least when his friend is away.
Oh, it's you.
Yeah. What is all this shit? It's not shit. The schedule alone took me 2 days to make.
Well, anyway, listen, you'll never guess.
Don't sit down.
What?
Don't sit down.
Look, I only came round because I got the most amazing news. Carly asked me, she asked me if she can come round to my house to revise. Amazing, yeah?
Just have a look at this for me, will you, Simon?
Sure. What is it?
It's my revision schedule.
What am I looking for?
Does it say anywhere, listen to Simon witter on about his futile crush on Carly DeMarto?
Oh, wow.
Don't be a dick.
What is
We're
what's
mates,
up a
and
will?
I want you to be the first...
Goodbye, Simon.
Come on, I just wanted to talk.
Goodbye!
Damn, Will.
Look, Simon, I told... Neil?
Hi.
Did you just see Simon?
No, your mum let me in. She is looking hot, if I may say.
You may not.
Right. Anyway, I need help revising.
What subjects do you do?
What, now?
This now.
Tech and design and PE.
PE?
Yep.
And that's an actual AS level at the school I now attend, is it? Oh, God, I don't know. Neil, go for a run or something.
Neil looks so
happy. Yeah, I hadn't thought of that. Nice one.
Neil jogged home, and later that evening, Simon had Carly where he'd always wanted her, in his bedroom. Unfortunately, she was fully clothed and discussing sociology.
And I suppose the big thing is that Parsons' description of a family is one of the traditional nuclear families, so that means that what he says might not be relevant for everyone.
Yeah, you could be stronger on that. Like, it clearly doesn't mean that all of his
he's
work
relaxed.
Family is invalid, but
cool.
It's a pretty important qualification.
Right, of course. Do you want to watch the DVD?
Overall, was his theory evolutionary or revolutionary?
Revolutionary.
Evolutionary.
Oh, shit, I knew that.
Oh, Simon, I've just brought you some biscuits.
What do you think you're doing? You
relax.
Know you're not allowed
relax.
In.
All relax.
All right, I'm going. Relax. Say hello to your mum for me, Carly.
Go away!
Relax.
God, she's a nightmare.
My mum's the same. It's like when I split up with Tom, she was always, like, hanging around when I was on the phone and stuff, trying to listen in.
Right, yeah, cool. Sorry, did you say that you split up with Tom?
I thought everyone knew.
Oh, yeah, of course. They do. He's a stupid, lanky twat, isn't he?
I don't really want to talk about it.
No, of course. I might put some music on. Jay got me into this.
Simon, do you mind if we do something different?
Not at all. What were you thinking? Maybe we could watch that DVD.
I am really shitting myself about my last exam. And I know you don't do geography, but would you mind helping me out with it a bit? I'm finding it really hard.
Now? No. No problem at all. My pleasure.
Thanks. So I thought we'd do longshore drift first.
Just turn that off.
I don't really get wave patterns.
So while Simon was cramming for an exam he wasn't sitting, Neil had his own learning difficulties.
How's your revision going?
Terrible. I think I pulled a hamstring.
All right, Benders. You miss me then?
Jay! All right, mate. Where have you been?
I've been busy.
Doing what?
I've met a girl.
Oh, yeah. What's this one, a Russian lap dancer?
No, her name's Chloe. And she goes to St. Clair's and we met at the bus stop and just got chatting.
Did you fuck her behind a bus shelter then?
No, Neil.
Fingers?
No.
Let's see a picture then. Yeah,
of a what the hell happened to Jay?
Can you stop talking like that?
Why?
Because I've never felt like this about a bird before.
Oh, man.
Chloe's special.
What more special than them twins that only wanted anal?
What, them? No, yeah. No, this is different. That was purely sexual. No, Chloe's a real lady.
If she's real, you should have a photo.
There you go.
Hot stuff.
Oh, she seems nice, mate.
Yeah.
She's doing a duck face, good.
You've nicked that off the, some the random girl's thing. Facebook site.
I thought you were revising.
I'm trying to, but it's almost impossible with the amount of noise you idiots are making.
Look, here we are together. I've got loads of them.
Doesn't prove anything.
Then do you love her, then?
Fuck off.
What is that denial? Will?
You fucking love her.
Shut up.
Oh, yeah, I thought I recognised her. She pulled David Glover, didn't she?
Don't be a tit, Neil. Of course she hasn't.
No, I think she has.
Look, one, she's not like that. And two, she doesn't know anyone from our school.
I'll ask. Oi, David! What?
Neil, don't. Seriously, don't. Please don't.
Nothing.
Twat. Look, honestly, Neil, she doesn't know anyone from our school, right? Ask her yourself. We're going to go down the Fox and Hounds after the last exam on Friday. Come along.
And what, not get served?
Nah, Chloe reckons she gets served there all the time.
Oh, and where are your wellies, Neil?
Why's that?
Because you'll be knee-deep in grammar school clunch.
So somehow Jay had an actual non-fictional girlfriend, but I wouldn't let it distract me from my new revision strategy. Staring at books.
See, Jay's a little bit different when his friends aren't around.
Hello. Hello. Sorry about the other night. It's just politics is really important to me and it's my last exam. I didn't mean to be a dick.
You were a dick.
Fine. Better get back to it.
Sure.
Why are you revising geography? You don't do geography.
They're not letting you take an extra AS level, are they? Oh, no, it's for Carly. She just needs a bit of extra help.
So when are you revising for your own exams? You know, the ones in the next couple of days?
I'm not really. I can always resit. How's your revision going?
Yeah, not bad. Pretty good. Got an excellent schedule sorted, colour-coded and balancing my time well. Got some drinks here to help, Pro Plus, that sort of thing.
Right.
And nothing's fucking going in. Nothing. I mean, look at this. I must have read about the accountability of legislatures to citizens 50 times, and I still don't know what it means. I'm starting to doubt if legislatures is even a word.
You gotta relax.
Doesn't look like a word anymore. None of them do. They're just like squiggles on a page.
You can't just try to cram it in your head. Not gonna
is
work
this
out.
Is a word?
Yes. Council.
Is it? It doesn't look right.
I think you probably need a bit more sleep, mate.
Yeah, gotta relax.
And maybe lay off the power drinks a bit?
These are full of electrolytes, which, if they exist, are good for the brain.
Think of your stomach, though. Even one of those drinks makes my shits come out too fast.
Mm.
I'm just saying, like rusty water.
It was a novel revision tip, I'll give him that. But when it came to advice, the real man to go to was Mr. Cartwright.
Right, Dad.
Uh-oh.
Right, Dad.
Dad, can I ask you advice about something?
Was it woman trouble?
Yeah, it is.
That little piece you were with the other day?
Chloe? Yeah. See, there's this guy at school, right?
So she's done you for this bloke? Well, that's a lucky escape. I thought she was a fucking pig.
Damn.
No, she hasn't dumped me, Dad. I think I love her.
So you're back with a pig?
Dad, we didn't split up. And please, don't call her a pig. It's just that I'm getting a bit jealous because I think she might have seen a few more people than I have.
I'd say that's a given, isn't it? If she's got off with more than one person, she's beating you.
Damn.
Look, mate, women are like fairground rides. Fucking mental. Your only hope is that when she wants some, you do the best you can with your tiny equipment. Oh, and check where she is the whole time. That's the only way you'll be totally sure she's not sucking off this other bloke.
Wow.
Right.
Probably
thanks,
not
Dad.
Best to listen to your dad.
Well, let's face it, she probably is. Fancy a beer?
Thanks for coming around. It's a really nice surprise.
That's all right. Just wanted to be near you, check how and where you are.
Oh, that's sweet. I just that's get this last bit done and then I'm all yours.
Cool. Did you pull David Glover?
What?
David Glover, did you pull him?
I don't know who that is.
It's just Neil said.
Oh, your friend Neil.
Yeah, do you know him too?
No, it's just you mention him a lot.
Right, of course. Anyway, do you want to come round mine tomorrow?
I can't.
What? Where are you going?
Well, nowhere.
So you'll be home then?
Yeah. Shouldn't you be revising as well?
Nah, I'm not allowed. Teachers say because I've got a photographic memory, it wouldn't be fair on the other kids.
If Jay's made-up memory skill was a bad revision plan, then Neil's topped it. Sitting on his ass, playing computer games.
Oh, Neil.
My strategy.
I really think you should be revising.
I am. This is football.
Well, what about your other subjects? What about tech and design?
I'll put that shelf up.
You say Tekken?
Was that for your exam?
Yeah. Well, it was 50% of it.
So whilst Neil wasn't revising for an exam he was taking, Simon was revising for an exam he wasn't.
Perfect answer. You're perfect at this.
God, I think I do know it. Amazing.
You've done really, really well. Honestly.
I couldn't have done it without you. Thank you so much.
Don't. Oh, she went in. Okay. Okay, cool.
Wow.
It's late. I should go.
Oh, sure.
God, maybe I'll actually pass geography now. Thanks again.
So he'd finally worn her down, and Simon didn't know whether to come in his pants or text his friends.
I was about to say enjoy it.
He did both.
We don't enjoy it that much. Relax, embrace it.
Yeah. It was the day Celebrate of my progress. Last exam, and I just got in a good 8 hours revision. Unfortunately, it was during the 8 hours I should have been sleeping.
What are you doing up so early? I thought the politics exam wasn't till this afternoon.
It is, but this way I can get a full morning of revision in. Better to be prepared. Also, I haven't really been to bed, so what's early?
I am worried about you, Petal. Have you had any breakfast?
No, I'm a bit, you know, my stomach.
Oh yeah, I do know. It would have killed you to wipe down the back of the toilet bowl.
So while the world was falling out of my arse, Simon was on top of it.
I can't believe she kissed me.
Calm down, it was only a kiss. Come back to me when you're wanking over her arse as she frigs herself off.
It was two kisses, actually, and she's already told me she's coming to the Fox and Hounds tonight, so I reckon there's more coming. How's Chloe?
Yeah, she's good. I've not seen much of her because she's revising, but I know where she's been. And I text her like 15, 16 times a day.
Not.
Just to keep in touch, you know?
Good idea.
He's about to lose his girl because of his dad's badass
Bebo,
advice.
Bebo, MySpace. Just to let her know that I'm thinking of her.
Like a stalker?
Fuck off.
Kind of. That's what it comes off as.
How's Count Spacula been getting on?
Going mental, I think. We'll probably see him when we finish. His last exam is straight after ours. Good luck with your PE.
Yeah, don't forget your kit.
Oh, fuck.
I see you still revising.
The moment
for
had arrived.
Gym
the
class.
Last exams. Simon and Jay both knew they had sacrificed their chances of good grades for a shot at love. A sweet, if remarkably short-sighted decision. While Neil had sacrificed his chances of keeping his balls in his boxer shorts. But then for them, it was all over, bar one last bollocking from Gilbert.
I've checked your texts. Despite almost making me vomit, they obviously weren't about the exam. Count yourself lucky.
Yeah, I was texting a girl, sir.
Well, good luck with her, Cartwright. All I can say is she can't be too keen because it didn't buzz once. Now piss off and let me get this final piece of hell over with.
Mm. Fuck me, it's Shaun of the Dead.
You look dreadful, mate. I'm really tired.
Why do you think I'm drinking these energy drinks? They perk me up.
Have you washed?
You can't revise in the shower, Jay. The books get wet.
Yeah, well, do us a favour and have a shower before tonight, yeah? 7 at mine.
You betcha.
Right, see you later then.
Yeah, good luck, Stinky.
It was the most important exam of my life, and as I sat there, two thoughts occurred to me. The first was, what's the point? Seriously, I mean, what is the point in being alive? And secondly, I really need a shit.
What's it, Mackenzie?
Sir, I need to go to the toilet. Again?
Yes.
I thought he intentionally looked
can't.
At him just to ignore him.
That'll be the fourth time in an hour. You'll have to wait.
I'm pretty sure you can't do that, sir.
If I have reason to believe you're cheating, I can. And I do. So I have. Now get on with your paper.
This might be the cringiest thing I think I've seen in a long ass time.
Oh, God, no.
Maybe.
Phil? Phil?
Oh,
oh,
no.
Oh. Oh.
Phil.
Oh.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh.
I thought it was a fart, sir. I thought it was safe.
In a term of low points, this was it. Literally the bottom. And yet as I waddled to the toilet, I felt strangely optimistic.
That'll get you a reputation.
Painful as it may seem, in a way I was free. Free to reinvent myself as whatever I wanted. Right after I changed my underpants. And at least I still had my friends, who waited a whole 10 minutes before going to the pub without me.
What do you think's happened to Will? He's not normally late, he's normally irritatingly early. I hope he's all right.
He's probably on the internet looking up the answers to the exam questions.
And then having a wank.
What? Well, it's impossible, isn't it?
I don't think I've ever been on the internet and not ended up having a wank. Do you think Chloe and Carly will get on?
Ah, oh, sure. It'd be like a cool double date, ending with both of us getting some.
Maybe they'll les off.
Neil, I've told you. Right, it's your last warning.
Do you honestly think you'll get served here?
Yeah, of course. I've got ID. G'day.
What can I get you?
Two jars of lager and a Coke.
Still all right?
Cheers.
Fucking hell.
Nice.
The one time we get served and I'm driving, bollocks. It'd be better to be sober when you see Carly. I mean, Chloe prefers it. You know what I used to be like with the old drink?
No.
Hello. Fuck me. I thought you dressed like a twat normally, but even for you, that's shit.
Where have you been?
Just finished my exam.
It started 6 hours ago.
I was a bit delayed.
You look mental. Take your tie off at least. Why are you wearing tracksuit bottoms?
The tracksuit bottoms are from Lost Property, as are my new underpants, which I won't show you.
And what's in that bag?
Well, in there are the trousers and pants I wore to school this morning.
What's going on? Are you doing a fashion show or something?
It's a long story, Neil, but the salient facts are these. Recently, I've had a bit of a nervy tummy due to stress, I think.
And all the energy drinks and Pro Plus.
Perhaps. And in the exam, I took a risk and it backfired. I went to fart and instead shit myself.
Are you joking?
No, I'm not.
In front of everyone.
Yup. Oh, my God.
I guess he's relaxed because it couldn't get any lower.
The school nurse spent 3 hours calming me down before I went back into an empty exam hall to finish. Hence, I'm late.
Or he's high.
Apologies.
How do you think you did?
I think I might have failed, Neil. I was a bit distracted.
Why don't you go home and change first? People are going to take the piss, mate.
Just to reiterate, I loudly shit myself in front of the school. There's no point trying to hide it. Life doesn't get much more embarrassing than that. This get-up is a mere fly in the ointment.
Have you gone mad?
Possibly. Hard to tell. Drinks, anyone?
Yes, he has.
Now, what could make this day worse? Oh, yeah. Not getting served.
Good day. Could I have a pint of lager, please?
Stella?
Sorry, you may have misheard. I said I'd like a pint of lager.
Yes, Stella.
Yes. Right. Well, what if I want 2 pints?
2 pints. There you go.
Well, what about this?
He's gonna get drunk, I reckon.
Being dressed like that is weird enough, but that bag's got his shitty clothes in it. No one brings a bag of shit to a pub.
Your dad does.
Does he?
Yeah. Your mum.
Damn. Damn. He's gonna be drunk out of his mind.
That'd be £6.20, please.
Interesting. I'll have another pint then, please.
Hi, Jay.
Chloe, darling. This is Neil and Simon. This is Chloe.
Nice to meet you.
Hi. All right.
Do you want a drink, babes?
Actually, Jay, could we go and have a quick chat outside?
Yeah, of course. I only want to be with you anyway. I see these twats all the time.
Yeah, go on, muff before mates.
She's going to dump him.
Just the two of us then. And Will.
He comes off as too controlling.
Yeah, sure he'll be joining us.
We'll still have a laugh, though. Me and you.
Yeah, of course.
Cheers, mate.
Cheers.
Nice idea. This is much more private. Oh, I've been wanting to kiss you for ages. I've missed you so much.
No, Jay. Listen, we need to talk.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, yeah. I love our talks, where you tell me about how you've fallen out with one of your mates and then how you've made up again later or something.
No, I mean, talk about us.
This is going to be awkward.
It's not you, it's me. I don't feel this is right anymore.
What's not right? What? Coming to the pub? Well, look, we can leave if you like.
No, Jay. Me and you. I just don't think it's right we see each other anymore. I think you're a bit too sensitive for me.
No, I'm not. I'm really not. I promise you.
But you are for me. And you're a bit needy, and it scared me because I'm not ready for that kind of thing. All the texting, all the calls, it's too intense, it's too much.
Well, I can change. I'll change. And, you know, I won't call you for ages, for weeks. Just, you know, tell me what you want me to be and I'll be exactly that. I'll be exactly that. Just please don't split up with me.
I'm sorry, Jay. I've made up my mind.
That's it.
I hope we can be friends.
Listen to your damn dad.
Right, yeah.
And your dad fucked you.
Of course.
Cool. Well, have a nice evening. I'll see you later.
I feel bad for Jay.
While Jay struggled to cope with his problems, I'd found an excellent way to deal with mine.
Because he was doing perfect early on, except fantastic. He was a little bit too hard on the...
No wonder so many people drink away their touching, whole lives. But... Barkeep, another pint, please.
Sure.
He was doing great.
So while I gave my liver a kicking, Simon and Neil were enjoying each other's company.
Oh, when are we going?
Hold on a second.
Carly.
Hi, Simon.
Hi. I've made you a CD.
Oh, right. Thanks.
Oh, it's nothing. Although the songs on there really do say a lot of the things that I want to say, but sort of better.
Simon, listen, there's something I've got to tell you.
Oh, God, I know. I feel it too. I've always felt it for years, and now it's happened, and here we are.
I'm back with Tom.
Well, damn.
You all right, Simon? Get us a seat, Carls. I'll get the drinks in, yeah?
Tom's a tall ass dude.
Oh, you're back with Tom.
Yes.
So that was what you wanted to say. Not that you love
me. I'm really sorry, Simon. Do you want to join us for a drink?
Nah. I better go back to Neil. I left him on his own.
Okay.
Maybe I should take that CD back as well, thinking about it.
Oh, can't I keep it?
No, I've got to have it back.
That's a shame. It looks really... Are those drawings of me?
They're not all of you.
And is that you?
No. See ya.
Goodbye, cruel pants.
Yeah, you should have thrown them away a long time ago. There's no recovering from that.
All right, you big puff. Done. Where's your bit, then? I thought you'd be out here up to your nuts and guts.
No, I had to give her the boot.
Did you? I thought you were really into her.
Nah.
Will, your
like,
friend needs help.
Frigid.
And or support.
She wouldn't have this threesome, even though I organised it with a top leather model. And my cock was too big for her.
That's all right, mate. It'll be okay.
That's too funny.
Have you two been getting off with each other? What's wrong with Jay?
It's okay. He split up with Chloe.
That's hilarious.
I dumped her. Make sure you tell people that.
Oh, man.
Yeah, of course, mate. What, even though it isn't true? Neil? Come on, let's go. This place is cursed.
Oh, my God,
oh,
it's haunted.
Boy.
No, Neil.
Well, it might be. Like one of those ghost stories, you know, like Harry Potter or the Bible.
Maybe I could have one
Harry
more
Potter.
I did shit myself in front of the school today.
Nope, we're off.
I'm only going to wait for Carly. No, she dumped me.
I wasn't dumped. It was more a mutual decision.
She mutually decided she fancied her boyfriend
well,
more.
Well, you can't get dumped unless you're going out.
Come on, Jay.
Weren't really going out.
Come on, mate. It'll be all right. We'll get you some chips.
I think now's a good time to tell you you're probably puking your car.
Great.
Nah, don't worry. Won't make this shit heap any worse. Shotgun.
You've perked up.
Yeah, well, I suppose there's plenty more clunge in the sea.
Yeah, that's it. And next term will be the top year, which means picking the birds.
Good way to look
at
it.
Oh, God, next term. Do you think anyone's going to remember my little accident?
Yes. Yes, they will.
Yes, of course they will.
Well, at least they won't call you Briefcase Mong anymore.
Well, that's good.
No, they'll call you Shit Pants Mong.
Or Shitty Shitty Bang Bang. Any more?
Wayne Pooney. Take shot.
Dr. Pooh.
The Lion, the Witch and the Specky Kid who shit himself.
Damn.
We can keep this up all summer, you know.
Brilliant. Looking forward to it.
Brad Shit.
Bumlog Millionaire.
All right. How about Vladimir Putin?
Oh?
Yeah, that reputation isn't going anywhere. I know kids that poop their pants in kindergarten that they still talk about in like high school. So there's no way you're getting away from that. Yeah, Jay started off the episode really, really good. Like I said, he was a little bit too... Well, what's the word I'm looking for? He was a little bit too hard on the idea of her touching him in appropriate places. Inappropriate places. But he was still doing good. Like, I was wondering what the hell was up with Jay. Like, I thought he was high or something. Like, okay, what happened? Because from last episode to this episode, it just, like, changed. And then he got that advice from his dad. Yeah, that's why it's always better to get a second opinion. Always. Don't just go with the first set of advice you get because that person might not know what the fuck they're talking about. Will was all the... Like, the momentum he had from the other episodes of starting off good but then ending bad, was not in this episode at all. He started off bad and just got worse. Like, he's the biggest, he would be the biggest loser of this episode. Easily. Yeah, so like, at some point, if I was Will, I would have just got up and went to the bathroom. I just said, fuck it. I don't care like what the teacher has to say at that point. If I know that I'm having issues, all right, fine. You can do whatever the fuck you want to do. I'm going to use the bathroom. I would have just got up and left. But, yeah, Simon, he did okay early on. Still a little bit, taking it a little bit too serious. Especially the way he handled his mom. That was not called for at all. Because I know damn well that a girl, if she saw a dude, like, treating his mom like that, how do you think she would imagine you treating her? Like, you got to show everybody respect. Why are you tripping on your mom like that? I get that your mom can be embarrassing sometimes, especially as a teenager. You probably see everything that they do as embarrassing, but oh well, he's a teenager. Maybe I'm giving him too much. Maybe I'm expecting too much, given that he's a teenager. So I mean, teenagers do that type of stuff. Neil. Only L he took the entire episode was for getting his pants for his training, but the dude was doing good. He was relaxed. He was not so tightly wound up. He, you know, was just going with the flow, and it seemed like it worked out with him for him. I didn't hear anything about him failing his exams, but then again, his exam was PE, so I don't know exactly how far he can go with that. Carly didn't really show any signs of being attention seeking. Well, it seemed like she was trying to like use Simon as like a rebound thing, maybe, but it wasn't fully committed because you can't really get too much out of a kiss. Like, you can kiss someone one day and then they don't want anything to do with you the next day. It happens, so don't get too caught up on a kiss. Let me see what else happened in this episode. Yeah, Jay was just too controlling. Way too controlling. Or he came off as if he was too controlling. Even though that's not what he probably is truly like. Because of his dad talking him into doing stuff like that. Like constantly like monitoring her and making sure that she's not doing this, that, and the other. That comes off as a controlling boyfriend. And that is something that people don't want. You have to make sure that... Sorry. You have to make sure that when it comes to a relationship, both of you are going at the same pace. If you're all the way up here and they're down here, it's not going to work out. If you're already planning like for the wedding and thinking about how many kids you're going to have and they're just now jumping into the relationship, it's not going to work out because people don't want that kind of commitment early on. They're still like... weighing the decision of whether or not you're the right person for them, and you're already like making all these plans, it makes the other person uncomfortable because it makes it seem like, okay, am I wasting this person's time by being in a relationship with them? Because they're already this serious about the relationship. If I get into this and then I learn that I'm not really into it, it's going to hurt them even worse because they've already like invested all this emotion and stuff into the relationship. So it's like, I'll just break it off now because I don't know what I want. You obviously are serious. I'm not. So let's end it now before anybody gets too hurt. So yeah, you just gotta take it at the pace that they're going. If they're not that serious, you can't be that serious either. And you know, you'll understand when someone has hit that point of being serious with you. I can't explain how, but you'll just know it. It's not like when you first kiss. Hell, it's not even when you first have sex. Like, it... I don't know really how to explain it. It's like they... Like, you start to pick up things that they do that they didn't really do before. Like, they start to show more of who they really are. And they start to want to do stuff with you that they normally probably wouldn't have wanted to do early on. Like the the things that would be considered annoying, I guess, they would be more okay with it. But at the same time, they're not over-enthusiastic. Because when you're first going out with somebody, you want to do everything for them because you want to be with them. But after a while, you, like, the things that you would have been okay with doing early on, you don't want to do anymore. Like, if a girl said, hey, could you come and pick me up from work? And she works, like, an hour and a half away. When you first date them, like, yeah, sure, I'll go pick you up. Yeah, let's go ahead and, you know, no problem. But then after a while, you're like, yeah, I don't really feel like driving an hour and a half. If they're still doing stuff like that long after the relationship has started, then that means that they might be the person that they might have hit that point where it's like, okay, well, they are taking this more serious. In other words, if they're treating you the way that they would not treat a stranger, like if someone they don't really know too well asked them to pick them up 2 hours away, chances are they're probably like, no, get a taxi or get a bus or call a relative or something. But they're not going to come out of their way to pick up somebody that is way out there. So that, in my opinion, is something that you could use to help learn whether or not they're serious about you. And Jay was just too serious early on. Yeah, usually that tends to happen with people that don't date a lot, because especially with guys, because like, it's easier for girls to find a guy because guys are more assertive when it comes to asking somebody out. Whereas a girl, it's like you have to follow the hints and clues. And if you're not somebody that dates a lot, it could be hard to like understand what those dates and or those clues and stuff are. So because you would expect, like, when you're first, or not when you're first date, if you're somebody that doesn't have a lot of confidence and you don't date a lot, you probably expect girls to like make the first move, and usually that's not going to be the case. So you'll have girls that actually like you, but because they didn't do stuff like directly, you assume they don't like you. So you miss an opportunity with somebody because you pretty much expect it too much, whereas you should have been the one to, you know, take the first steps. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much all I have to say, really. I can't really think of too much else. On a side note, I did find the actor who, James Buckley, I found his Twitch channel, Completed Mate. I do have it listed on my channels that I host on Twitch. So when they go live, chances are you'll see it on my channel as well. I believe the views that appear on my channel go to their channel, so it's not taking any views away from them. If anything, it would add, depending on how many people watch my channel. Not a lot, but you know, any little bit helps, I guess. Speaking of streaming, I will be streaming again tomorrow. I'll probably be playing Final Fantasy VII again. I have been playing it off camera, so you will have missed some stuff, like the cross-dressing scene and Don Corneo, Alps, Ghost Graveyard, and the Battle on the Pillar. I've completed all of that. I wanted to do it on camera, but my internet was acting funny the last time I streamed, and I'm still in contact with Spectrum to try to figure out what's going on with it. But until then, I'll probably have to stream shorter. I won't be able to do like 4-hour streams anymore, so at least until I figure out what's going on with the internet. But I will be streaming again tomorrow, same time, 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So I look forward to seeing you guys there. If you want to go and check it out, my Twitch channel is in the description box, right underneath the set of hashtags. It should say follow me on Twitch at twitch.tv/Devon_DaVinci if you want to follow me. And I look forward to seeing you guys there. Come when I'm streaming live. I'll usually have some type of notification or some way of letting you know that my Twitch is up, so you can come to the chat and talk to me live, ask me questions. Not necessarily recommendations for reactions and stuff like that, but, I mean, I'll hear you out. With that being said, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up. I'm Devon DaVinci. Hopefully you've just been a little bit more enlightened, or if you haven't, just do the opposite of what most of the people in this show does, and you'll be good. So, that's it. I look forward to seeing you guys in a future video. Until then, I'm going to give you the deuces, and I'm signing out. Deuces. Oh. Why the hell is my... muscle twitch.